This is Pastor Blazing ATM, and the church service starts right now. No, I mean really, it's next, and it starts right now. For more information, go to YouTube/PastorBlazingATM or Joseph Holland, and go to BlazingEntertainment.com for exclusives.
Wake up to the morning light, wipe away the lonely night, let a brand new day wash over you. Closer, you can put your head on my shoulder. Yeah, yeah. So baby, hold on, just another day or two. I can see the clouds are moving faster now, and the sun is breaking through. If you can hold on to the one that's holding you, there is nothing that can stop this crazy love from breaking through. We're breaking through.
Had a good time, I'm telling you, this week. Enjoyed the goodness of the Lord, and that's the Lord. And Brother Landon found his call last night on the grandson and told me, Brother Frankie, he said, I'm going to be a state worker. He said, that's why. He said, don't do nothing.
Six guys
standing at home. Well, I guess that's all right. Amen. John, these preachers. And old John over there, I'll show you. Yeah. I'd sing like that and cut me a CD. Amen. If the word of the Lord and pastor's wife, before she's out of concert. Rapture such a place, but don't worry. I'm one of the witnesses sent back to catch you folks right. Amen.
And Luke chapter
22 tonight. And the Lord will be with me. And verse 31, if you have your Bibles. And how many's got them old King James Version Bibles?
Amen.
Don't be ashamed of packing, folks.
Amen.
And taking with me, sometimes it's hard. I used to take mine in a place of land to rest. I used to a backslider to go together. And I take them in the restaurants with me if one went. I settled down home in church. I took my future son-in-law there before he Courtney got married, but Darrell. And maybe he's not ashamed of the Lord. And I took him to the banker to get his loan for his trailer and to introduce him and help him. And so we get out of the car, and here he comes with that big King James Version Bible. And I thought, where are you going, son? We're not going to meet him. We're going to the banker. Amen. And we get him there and get him in the booth, you know, and in comes the loan officer, you know, He looked at Darrell, said across the table from him there, and he said, son, what can I do for you? Darrell said, it's not what you can do for me, but what can I do for you? Amen. Do you know the Lord?
Amen.
Not at all, Lord. Amen. And then Joyce took him to the courthouse to get the marriage license. And believe me, she's in June, you embarrass her this second, so she said to get out of the car, and Darrell gets that big King James Version Bible, you know. Of course, it ain't no bigger than this, but you think your boy looked like a big suitcase coming.
Yeah.
And she said, Darrell, you don't need to take your Bible. We're going to get married now. He said, are you ashamed of it? And you know, every day you thought about putting the pressure to you. You go tonight and go into a restaurant or go into Hardee's down here or a pizza place. Pack that Bible in there and see how many spirits will hit you in the face.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. Get it out and take it to Walmart. Walk down the aisle with it. See if the devil won't start packing you. Pack you on the back.
Mm-hmm.
Thank God. But don't be ashamed of it, folks. It's your only hope. No, listen to me. I said it's your only hope.
Mm-hmm.
In the word of the Lord tonight, verse 31. Help me preach tonight if you would. The Bible said in verse 31, and the Lord said to Simon, Simon, behold, Satan desires to have you, that he may sift you as wheat. Now, folks, I'm talking to somebody. I feel like the Lord has spoke to me, said he'll appear. Amen. And the Bible said, but I have prayed for thee, that thy faith faileth not. When thou art converted, strengthen thy brethren. And he said unto him, Lord, I am ready to go with thee both to prison and to death. Isn't that easy motion, folks, when you're on the mountain?
Yeah.
And the Bible said, and he said, I tell thee, Peter, the cock shall not crow this day before thou shalt twice deny thou knowest me. And he said unto them, when I sent you without purse and scrips and shoes, lack you anything? And he said, nothing. Then said he unto them, but now he that has a purse, let him take it, likewise his scrips. And he that hath no sword, let him sell his garment and buy one. Shall we pray? Father, we come to you in Jesus' name. And I'm asking you, precious God, that you would help me, that you would move for me. And I'm asking you, precious God, Lord, that you would just touch, and Lord, that you would just move. I'm asking tonight, Lord, that you would just come by our way. Help our people here tonight, Lord. Strengthen our hearts, precious God. You know what I need to say. You know what I need to hear, precious God. Father, let them feel the burden. Let them feel, Lord, the love. Heavenly Father, help me to be gentle. Help me to be kind. Lamb of God, help me to be humble. And Lord, I pray to do this, then Christ must stand forth before me. And I must hide behind you. Lamb of God, here tonight, because I know their heavy hearts and their troubled minds, their troubled homes and troubled marriages. And Father, I know their needs, spiritually, physically, and financially. And Lord, I know we're in the closing hour. Satan has come down with great wrath, knowing that he has but a short time, wearing out the patience of the saints of the Most High God. Now, Lord, in the name of Jesus, bless this man of God, his family, bless this church, Lord, and bless these visiting preachers, Lord, and saints of God. And Lord, we'll give you the glory and honor in Jesus' name with Satan's power bound. And everyone shout amen.
Amen.
If I can throw both messages in together, amen, would ask the Lord to help me to do that. And that would be that I would deal, amen, what to do, amen, in your doctor's power.
Amen.
Y'all with me here?
Amen.
And if I could go the other way, I would preach, you're headed for trouble.
Amen.
And y'all with me?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And I'm going to tie it all back in to one. Somebody shout amen to God.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. The Lord will be with me. Would you slip up those hands one more time?
Amen.
Would you slip up those hands one more time? Satan, I bind you. You foul devil. You foul spirit. In the name of Jesus of Nazareth, we cover this place, in the blood of the Son of God. Lord, in the name of Jesus, I thank you.
Jesus.
Lord, I praise you.
Jesus.
I honor you. I glorify you. In the name of Jesus. And I hear somebody shout, amen to God.
Amen.
Peter, amen, is headed for trouble.
Yeah. Yeah.
Can I hear somebody shout, amen to God?
Amen.
And it's just like all the rest of us here, folks. You're going to have your days, amen, of trials and troubles.
Right.
And financial burdens, spiritual burdens, physical, family, children, in-laws, outlaws, and all the other laws.
Amen.
Can I hear somebody shout, amen?
Amen.
It's coming. Let me hear. But there's a lot of things could be avoided if we would just pray.
Right. Mm-hmm.
With me here.
Right.
You here tonight, and you have lost your prayer life.
Yeah.
And there is no drawing of the Spirit of God.
Right.
to draw you to the altar of prayer,
oh,
you are headed for trouble.
Amen.
Y'all with me here? Thank God. Now, I'm a cross preacher. I'm a blood preacher. But I believe that till you get saved, amen, you need to maintain that prayer life.
Amen.
It's not that you're trying to earn anything, that you're not trying to buy anything.
Right.
You're not trying to persuade God.
Right.
But you just want that relationship with the Lord.
Amen.
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 Can I just take the time? This is what I'm supposed to preach. Amen. Can I talk to you here tonight? Well, can I just, from my heart, amen, to people that I love.
Yes.
And I hope that you love me.
Yes.
You're with me here, and I want you to tell me the truth.
Yes.
Talk to me. But I feel a spirit of prayerlessness.
Come on.
Amen. My good friend, Brother Garry Starr, in County, and some of you was there. And he's been calling the last 2 or 3 days, and Brother Garry, if you get this, don't hold it in me. Amen. I'm going to call him. But for revival. And I was in his church, and stand behind the sanctuary in the little cabin, and I'd go out and preach. I mean, we started on Sunday night, and I'd go out, and I was so burdened because I left the church on a Sunday night anyway.
Yeah.
But the first night I thought, well, this again. When I get rid of this weary feeling in my heart that maybe I shouldn't have been here on Sunday night in this home church. But Monday night, the same spirit was there again. Amen. Every night, I'd go out from the church, and no one there but me, no cell phone service. And I'd go in there and fall before the Lord and take my Bible. And I'd say, Lord, what is wrong? There is something wrong here.
Yeah.
Amen. Lord, am I out of your will? I mean, see, so many of us, when we get down and we get that burden on our heart, we want to pass the buck.
Right, right.
I mean, we hear the church is not moving, the Lord's not moving, well, it's the congregation. They sung the wrong songs, you know.
Yeah.
Amen. But the preacher preached the wrong message, or whatever. But I'm trying that the Lord doesn't move. First one that I examined, the Bible said the husband must be first partaker of the fruit.
Right.
Amen. The first one that I take inventory, I'm not, amen, like the religious man that looked down upon the publican and said, I'm glad I'm not like him.
Yeah.
Amen. Y'all with me here? But right here was the first one I took inventory. Lord, am I not supposed to be here? Y'all with me? Am I not supposed to be here? Amen. If you have sent me here, and then where is your presence?
Uh-huh.
Yes. Amen. Yeah. And I said, Lord, did not Moses say, God, if you don't go up with me, I'm not going.
Right.
Amen. And I said, Lord, if you have sent me here, I'm here. Uh-huh. Amen. There are not enough demons and devils of hell can move me from where I'm at.
Uh-huh.
Amen. But Lord, if you're not with me, I'm packing my bags and I'm going home.
Yeah.
Amen. Thank God. And that was probably on Monday night, Tuesday night. Same thing, man. I go and, amen, I pray and seek God, study for the message, going on fire. And when I did, it's like somebody took a bucket of water and just pushed it on me, amen. And all I tell you, I'd go back to the building. And then that day, God spoke to me. He said, I'm going to show you, son, what's wrong. Amen. And so I just sitting right over here where the brother is sitting, not a message, not a thought on my heart. And I said, God is going to speak to me. Amen. And about the time Brother Starr said, it's time to preach. Amen. We want our brother to come. And the Lord said, I want you to preach on a prayerless church.
Yeah.
Amen. A prayerless people.
Come on.
Amen. And I stood up and come to the pulpit. Brother Starr Stern. He's a little fellow that packs a big stick.
Amen.
He rules his church. He rules the saints of God. Amen. Anything.